Howdy, it's Kyle. Examining physical world currency in the forms of banknotes and coins. Over the past few years, I've had the chance to travel to several different countries, and whenever I travel somewhere else, I like to bring back some of the currency just to kind of have as a collection. And one thing I've noticed through the years is that most other countries have prettier money than ours. It's more colorful, it feels better, and ours are just really bland, which is really interesting for a country that worships money like ours does. So in this video, I'm going to take a look at some of the collection of some of the currencies I have of the places we visited, but also the currency of some of the largest countries in the world to show what they look like. And not this is not going to be about exchange rates and anything financial, just about the actual physical currency and how it looks. And also, I have a pretty interesting collection of mid-20th century German marks and British coins and things as well. So let's take a look at some other people's money to see how it looks. I'm going to start off by talking about Canadian money, and many Americans haven't seen Canadian money, but as you can see here, this is a $5 banknote. It's blue, but I'm going to show some stock footage of other Canadian notes. As you can see, they're each different colors and just very colorful money here. And this is actually an older photo. There's a new $10 bill here, and one of the sides has a vertical orientation, which is fairly common for many countries to their money to have a vertical orientation on one side. But going back to the one here, you can just see it's just a little bit just different. The paper is more of a wax paper. This part's see-through. It's got a pretty cool look to it. I just think Canadian money has a really nice look to it, just being more colorful than ours. You may have heard the terms loonie and toonie. That's in reference to the Canadian $1 and $2 coins. The loonie is got the loon on it, and that's why it's called that, and the $2 toonie has the grizzly bear on it. And Canada, like most of the other countries in the British Commonwealth, have an image of the current monarch on one side, this case the late Queen. These are two Canadian quarters, one from 2022, one from 1956. You can see the moose on one side here. And again, on the other side are photos of the Queen, but as you can see here, the Queen ages through time on the currency. And here are a couple of older Canadian nickels with a beaver depicted on it. As you can see, the older one isn't even perfectly round. Here are a couple more interesting Canadian coins. The one on the left is a one from 1967 denoting the Canadian centennial, has a bobcat on there, and the one on the right is a 1964 50-cent piece. And with these being older coins, you can see the depiction of the younger queen on the other side. So overall, I would say that Canadian money is very attractive. I like the colorful nature of it. It feels very nice with that paper. I like the depiction of animals like loons, bears, bobcats, and moose. So I would say the neighbor to our north has better looking currency than ours. Moving just off the North American continent into the Caribbean, these are Eastern Caribbean dollars or EC dollars. These are used by all of the former British colonies in the Caribbean that are independent nations but now have populations under 150,000. And being part of the British Commonwealth, you can see the Queen depicted on the money here, but the Queen doesn't age on the currency in the EC dollars like she does on the currency in Canada and British pounds. These are Eastern Caribbean $1 coins. I like the depiction of the ship on one. And as you can see, the Queen does age on the coins in the EC, but I don't believe the Caribbean is going to be moving over to the King on their currency. From what I understand, most of these countries want to kind of break away from the British Commonwealth, and we're kind of staying with it just out of respect to the Queen. But now that she's died, and I think they might be moving away from that, so you might no longer see British monarchs on Eastern Caribbean money. These are Eastern Caribbean nickels. The one on the left is much more recent. The one on the right isn't even round. That's a much older one. But what's interesting about these is that they're plastic. They're very low denomination, and these are just plastic coins. So Eastern Caribbean dollars, very colorful. They feel very nice, and I think also better looking currency than American money. Next, I want to talk about Mexican pesos. I don't actually have any pesos to show you, so here's some stock image of the current Mexican currency. And like the other currencies we've seen, it's much more colorful with each bill being a different color. You have some vertical orientation on some of these, although the paper feel is not as nice as some of the wax paper ones. But as you may have noticed, not all of the bills are the same size. The larger denomination ones are longer than the smaller denomination ones, and that's pretty common throughout the world in terms of their paper bills. I do like the look of the peso coins with the two-tone gold and silver. These are the most recently circulated banknotes in Mexico, but you will see some of the older ones still in circulation if you go there. But I do like the depictions of many of the natural things, such as jaguars and whales, birds and butterflies. I can certainly appreciate when a country puts something besides a politician on its currency. Heading over to North Africa, this is the Moroccan currency, the dirham. And like all the other ones we've seen so far, they come in different colors depending on the denomination of the bill. All of the bills in Morocco feature the current king on them, and as you can see, the larger denominations are longer than the smaller denominations. The paper used for the Moroccan dirham feels like the same paper that's used for US dollars. So Morocco, another country with colorful currency, and I think I do prefer the idea of the larger denominations being longer than the smaller denominations, so let me know what you think about that in the comments. Keeping it in Africa, these are West African francs, often abbreviated XOF. These are used by many of the former French colonies in West Africa, including Senegal, Côte d'Ivoire, Togo, and Benin. Like all of the other currencies we've seen, each denomination is a different color. And there is a difference in the size of the bill depending on the denomination, but for the West African francs, the difference in size is much greater than that for the pesos or for other currencies. But this is another currency where many of the things depicted on it are animals or other aspects of nature. But you will also see historic tribal artifacts and masks depicted on some of the currency. And the paper used for this currency feels pretty cheap. It feels almost like the paper they use for the money in the Monopoly board game. So yeah, these are West African francs. Many of the countries that use these might be changing their currency soon, but this is what they use right now. Okay, so moving over to the EU, these are euros. And again, another currency where each of the denominations is a different color, and another one where the size difference depends on the denomination. But one thing that's different between euros and the other ones with size differences is that the height of the bills is different depending on denomination. So you can see the 50 is taller than the 20, which is taller than the 5. But I do have to say, the depictions on the euros are pretty bland. I know they have a lot of countries they have to represent, but still, this is pretty boring stuff here. So this is what some of the euro coins look like, and just like Mexican pesos, there's a two-tone aspect with gold and silver. And I like the idea of the coins being different colors. I think that's pretty cool. I'm not sure why we have so many euros, but we're like euro rich. I'm not sure about the conversion rate, but I think this is enough to buy an apartment in Vienna. Heading over to the UK, where they use the British pound. Even before Brexit, UK did not use the euro. It's always been the British pound. So this was the last 50 pound note that featured the Queen. And here are the new notes that feature the King. This is how the last 1 pound coin looked with the Queen on it. And now you've got the King on the new coins. And here you have the non-monarch side of the British notes that feature some historic figures. So again, multicolored bills, but more subdued with the UK. Here are some older British coins from the 1960s and 70s, and I like that 50 pence piece where it's not really a circle. And here are a couple of older British coins from 1955 for 1 and 2 shillings. And here you can see the Queen age on this series of coins from the 1950s to 2017. So now I want to show some old German marks. This was the currency used in Germany up until 2002 when it started using the euro. These are some coins that my late father-in-law had. He was from Germany, living there at this time, and I'm going through some of his old coins, and it's like 1953, 52, 51, and I'm thinking, hope these don't go back much further than this, but 1950 is the oldest coin I have here. So these are just some of the old German marks that you see distributed not long after the war. So these are from 1950. I like the one of the girl planting a tree. Just kind of shows rebirth of Germany after a horrible war. The other side of those old German marks just has the number on it, but it is pretty cool to see some just past World War II German currency. So those are all of the foreign currencies that I have in my house, but I want to take a look at a few other major currencies. So these are Japanese yen banknotes. You can see sometimes people or buildings on one side and some aspect of Japanese culture on the other. And I really like that 2,000 yen note. It looks really old, like something they would have been using 500 years ago. And as you might expect with Japanese currency, it's not very colorful, much more subdued. And I want to highlight some of these Japanese coins. Check out a couple of these that have a hole in the middle of it. That's an interesting touch, and I wonder how many currencies worldwide have a hole in the middle of a metal coin. But nonetheless, I think this is very nice currency for one of the largest economies in the world. Okay, so now to look at the banknotes of the most populous nation on Earth, India. All of the banknotes feature Mahatma Gandhi regardless of the denomination. However, as is often the case, they are different colors and different length depending on the denomination. I like the back of this 500 rupee note that depicts Gandhi's glasses overlaid on some Hindi text. And here's a collection of Indian coins throughout time. Many of these are in current circulation. So India is now the most populous nation on Earth, and the rupee is one of the most heavily traded currencies on Earth. And the last currency I want to show is of China, the yuan, or sometimes referred to as the renminbi. As you can see, the banknotes are in different colors and all feature the Communist Party Chairman Mao. So overall, I would say these are not very interesting looking banknotes. They all look very similar with the same image and a very similar symbol. And here are some of the coins in circulation in China. These coins kind of remind me of euros, with just a number and a very simple layout. So yeah, the yuan, the currency of the second most populous country on Earth. So that's my look at some of the world currencies, and I certainly can't go over all of them, but if you're aware of a pretty interesting looking currency from a different country on Earth, let me know in the comments section. But if you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up to let me know you approve, and subscribe to this channel if you're interested in learning more about geography from a nerd. But yeah, thanks for watching. Geography King, signing out. I'd like to give a special thanks to my superior patrons for their support. If you're interested in supporting the channel, you can check out my Patreon page with the link in the description. And as always, thank you very much.